Hello, today I will be teaching you how to download and install Unity Engine into your computer. First, open up your browser and search for Unity. You will then be able to see unity.com, which is their official site. Click on it. At the top of the official site, you will be able to see the Get Started button. When you click on this button, you will be able to see several pricing plans. You can click the individual tab here and download Unity for free from the personal section here. All functions we need to build a game are included in this personal version, so we will have no issues. I will click Get Started here to download Unity Hub. To download Unity Hub, I will click the Download for Windows button. I am able to download the Unity Hub setup in this way. I will open the file now. After opening it, I will install it onto my PC. After the installation has been completed, you can open up Unity Hub in this way. We are given the option to download this version of Unity Editor. I will skip its installation for now to show you how to use Unity Hub. You can click the Installs tab here to install a new Unity editor. To install one, you can click Install Editor here. You will then be able to see the versions that they recommend. You must be wondering what the LTS here means. LTS stands for long-term support. Long-term support means that if we build a game using an older version, there may be some errors when newer versions are released. So when using versions with LTS, they will provide newer versions to us as an update. Therefore, we will receive updates for these versions from time to time. You can even download and use versions without LTS with no issues. When creating personal projects, you will have no issues using versions of the editors without LTS. When we develop apps for commercial purposes, we usually use versions with LTS. I will download the 2022 version from here. After selecting the version, we will be able to see all possible add-ons here. I have already installed Microsoft Visual Studio Community 2022 as the dev tool. If you need a Visual Studio ID for scripting during your game development, you can download it from here. You can also see which platforms these games we create can be built in under the Platforms drop-down here. According to your preference, you can tick the boxes here for your preferred build supports. I will click the Android Build Support box here as I am building a game to be supported by Android phones. When you scroll down, you will be able to see several build supports. If you want to build a web game, you can select an option like WebGL. iOS Build Support is also available. After that, I will click Continue. You have to then agree to the licensing agreement and click Install. You can then see the Unity editor along with its add-ons being downloaded and installed. The time taken for the downloads to complete will depend on your internet speed. The installation of the Unity editor has now been completed, so I will close it. When we come to the Installs tab, we are able to see the Unity version we just installed. We can also see the available build supports here. As you can see, the Android build support that I added can be seen here. If, for example, you wanted to add the iOS or WebGL build supports to the version we have already downloaded, you should click on the Settings button here and select Add Modules. We can then install more build supports from this list. Build supports that have already been installed have installed written next to them. To install a new build support, you should tick the one you want and click the Install button. This build support will then be downloaded and installed into our Unity editor. I am not going to install this right now. You can see a pop-up saying no active licenses on Unity Hub. To activate a license, we have to first sign in to Unity Hub. To sign in to Unity Hub, you have to have a Unity account. You can either create an account here or log in using your Google, Facebook, or Apple account. I am going to use my Google account to log in. You can now see that I have logged in to Unity Hub. You have to now click Manage Licenses and go to the Licenses tab to add a new license. You have to click Get a Free Personal License here. You have to then click the Agree and Get Personal Edition License button. We will then receive a personal license as seen. You can see the activation and expiration dates here. Unity Hub also has a tab called Learn. You can watch the tutorials and beginner courses that have been created by Unity in this section. They have provided us with a lot of information here. We can watch one of these courses by selecting one and clicking the View on Unity Learn link. We can also use Unity Hub to download alpha and beta releases. We can see the 2023 alpha and 2022 beta versions here. You can install and check these versions out. But these versions may show errors as they are currently being developed. These versions are not suitable for development. You can try using them to create your personal projects. But they are not suitable for creating commercial products. You can also see this download archive link under the Archive section. When you click on this link, it takes you to the Unity Download Archive website. You can use this website to download older versions of Unity by going through the various tabs available. You can find some very old versions here. To download one of these versions, you should click the Unity Hub button next to the version you want and click Open. It will open up the version you have selected and it can be installed in the same way that we did before. We can see the projects that I have created earlier in the Projects tab here. We can create a new project by clicking the New Project button. We can see the various categories of projects that we can create here. These include 2D, 3D, 2D URP, AR, and VR projects. We can create a project by selecting a category, naming the project, and clicking Create Project. After creating the project, it can be edited using Unity Editor. I hope that you have learned something new from this video. See you again for our next video. Goodbye.
Thank you so much for watching the video. We're so glad that you joined us on the Render Island channel today. We're always creating new content for Unity developers, so please subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell. I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next one.